हेलो स्टूडेंट, चैप्टर नंबर 7 कंगोज ऑफ ट्राइंगल। हियर द इम्पोर्टेंट सम्स डेट कैन बी आस्क फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर इन योर एग्जाम आर गिवन, ओके, एंड वी सॉल्व दैट वन। इन दैट फर्स्ट वन, इन एन आइसोस्केलियन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी, ए बी इक्वल टू ए सी, सो दैट एंगल ऑपोजिट टू द इक्वल साइड्स आर इक्वल, ओके। Here isosceles triangle ABC is given and two equal sides are given. Isosceles means two sides are equal. You just prove that the opposite side, here the figure we have, okay, here AB and AC, these two sides are equal, so you just prove that the opposite angle, okay, angle to the opposite of equal sides are equal, means B and C are equal. You just prove that one, okay. So I just draw AD, line segment AD, which is make 90 degree, means that is perpendicular to BC, okay. So in a triangle ABC, AB equal to AC, which is given because that is ABC is isosceles triangle, okay. So side AB equal to side AC, that is given, okay. Now side AD equal to side AD, I just draw AD which is perpendicular to BC, so AD is common side between ABD and ACD, this one, okay. So that is common side, okay, and this one is for triangle ABD and triangle ACD, for these two triangle, okay. And AD is perpendicular, means make 90 degree here, so angle ADB, this one ADB equal to angle ADC, ADC, this one, okay, both are making 90 degree, okay, right angle. So that is, this is right angle, so BC is opposite side of right angles and AC is also opposite side, okay. So that one is hypotenuse, this one is right angle and one side is given, okay. So according to RHS congruency, okay, RHS congruency, triangle ADB congruence to triangle ADC, ADB and ADC are congruence, okay. So according to corresponding parts, okay, these two triangles are congruent, so their corresponding parts are also equal. Now corresponding parts means, look, D and D, these two are triangles, angles are equal, same, these two angles are equal and these two are equal, therefore angle B equal to angle C, okay. So here it's proved that the B and C are equal, okay. Second question, look in the figure, look here and show that triangle ABC and ADC, these two triangles are congruent, and also AC is bisector of BAD. AC, this one is bisector of BAD. Okay, so here already I drew that one. Okay, coordinator ABCD is there, and I just draw AC. Okay, here measurement of AB, AD, BC, and DC are given. And according to that one, okay, first we join AC, okay, AC. Now we want to prove that first one is triangle AD ABC congruence with triangle ADC, and second one is AC is bisector of ABAD. Okay, now AC. Now first one, in a triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Look, triangle ABC in this one and ADC in this one. Okay, AB equal to AD, which is 5 centimeter. Look, AB and AD both are 5 centimeter. It's given. Same, BC equal to DC, that is 7.5 centimeter. Okay, BC and BC both are 7.5 centimeter, means they are equal. Okay, and AC is common side between that two triangles. So AC equal to AC, that is common side. Look, one side, two side, and three sides are there. Okay, so according to SSS congruency, both the triangles are congruence, means triangle ABC congruence triangle ADC. So first one is true. Now second one, okay, directly you just write down. See, since triangle ABC congruence with triangle ADC, okay, they are congruence, so the corresponding parts, okay, so corresponding parts are equal. Okay, therefore angle BAC equal to angle DAC. Look, these three sides are equal, so both triangles are equal. So according to that one, these two angles are equal. Same, these two angles are equal. So angle BAC means this one, and DAC means this one, both are equal. And BAD is addition of BAC and DAC. Okay, and in that, AC is divide that to that triangle into two equal parts. Okay, both are equal. So according to that one, therefore AC is bisector of angle BAD, because it's divide BAD into two equal parts. Both the triangles angles are equal. Both these triangle angle are equal. AC is divide that angle into two equal parts. Okay, so AC is called bisector for BAD, angle BAD. Okay, same for third one. Look here, in the figure, AC and BD both bisected at O point. Then what is the length of CD? What is length? Here length of AB is given. Just find out length of CD. Okay, now here we prove. Look, in this one, AC and BD are bisector of each other, because it's given AC and BD bisected at O, means both are bisector of each other and both intersect at O. Okay, and according to that one, look, BD is bisector of AC, so BD divide AC into two equal parts, so OA equal to OC. Number one, OA equal to OC. Okay, and same, AC is bisector of BD, means AC divide BD into two equal parts. So according to that, BO equal to OD. Okay, so BO equal to OD, number two. Okay, so in a triangle AOB, look, AOB and COD in triangle AOB and triangle COD. These two are given. OC equal to AO equal to OC, BO equal to OD. Okay, because they are bisectors. Okay, and same, look, angle AOB COD. Angle AOB equal to angle COD. Why they are equal? Look, two crossing lines are there. These two angles are opposite angles. Which type of opposite? They are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. So they are equal. So two side and included angle is there. So according to two side means SAS, two side and included angle. So according to SAS congruency, both triangle AOB congruence to triangle COD. AOB and COD both are congruence. Okay, they are congruence means their corresponding parts. So corresponding parts are equal, and according to that one, AB and DC are equal because they are corresponding parts. Okay, so AB equal to DC, AB equal to 4 centimeter is given, so DC is also 4 centimeter. Okay, so student, with this video I have sent you a photo of these sums. Practice it yourself, and if you don't understand, watch the video again and learn it again and again. Okay, and practice the other sums like that and try to solve yourself. Okay, thank you.